Hello and welcome to the next Friday Fun Fact. May is Mystery Month, and while I'm sure all of you know what a mystery is, when it comes to libraries, it gets a bit more complicated than that. What's the difference between a mystery, a thriller, and a horror story, and how do libraries decide? Let's get started with some definitions, courtesy of Genreflecting, a guide to popular reading interests. In it, each has its own chapter, but there is some overlap. Mysteries are defined by, well, the mystery, a puzzle or problem that must be solved by deduction. While you can have little m mysteries in other genres, a capital M mystery has solving the riddle be absolutely essential to the plot. The scope of these stories can vary, but are never very large. For example, cozy mysteries usually deal with just one small town. Thrillers, on the other hand, are more action-y. While they're also about revealing and concealing information to solve a problem, thrillers require the deduction to take place in dangerous situations. The main character might get hurt. Thrillers also tend to have a wider scale. You typically don't foil nuclear Armageddon in mysteries. Thrillers and mysteries are a bit like squares and rectangles. You can have a mystery in a thriller, but not a thriller in a mystery. Finally, horror is the odd one out here. It's the most emotional of the three, purely focused on eliciting an emotional response, in this case, of fear or terror. Other stories can have horror elements, but a pure horror story is all about scaring the reader. So they're all different, but what are the rules when it comes to libraries? Well, the actual library records for each book use something called the Library of Congress subject headings. The Library of Congress puts out a list of the main subject headings, for this purpose, the Library and Archival Materials list, and each has a code. When a book is published, it's assigned a few of these. We then use these headings to determine how we describe the books in the respective records so that they're organized and findable. That said, most librarians in your public library don't do this back-end cataloging. Here, the wonderful people at the Mid-Hudson Library System do that for us. Shout out, you guys are great. In the physical library space, what we're concerned with is how easy it is for a person to find what they're looking for. If we put a book somewhere the public doesn't think to look, then it won't be read and will eventually get weeded earlier than it could have been. And that's not cool, we want all of our stories to be read and enjoyed. Here at the LaGrange Association Library, our mysteries have their own section, with thrillers usually going in our main fiction section. Horror tends to be shelved either in our main fiction section or in our sci-fi fantasy section if it overlaps there. Think Lovecraft or Mary Shelley. This does differ from library to library. Some might have thrillers and mysteries together, some might have all horror in the main fiction section because they don't have a sci-fi fantasy section. You start with the basic rules, then tweak them to suit your specific audience. So what do you think? Do you agree with what libraries do? Do you disagree? Let us know in the comments. If you're intrigued, here are some books to check out. They're all in our library system. Like and subscribe for more Friday fun facts, and I'll see you next time.